It takes serious passion and an awareness of the level of need of the students and the community and the environment, and then a determination to help meet that need and help help create others or empower others that will assist the community in meeting the needs of having critical thinkers that are hard workers with character. I always call it the ABCs of education. It's academics, behavior, and character. Make your academics good, your behavior better, and your character the best, and nothing else matters.
And one of the things you talked about in severing the gap was that the students learned about who they were and where they came from. Why don't schools teach that? Why do we have to have a summer program to teach that? Why can't schools teach that?
Well, schools have become overly focused on testing, standardized testing, state testing, so much so that education has been made into a tip, tool, or technique for students, and teachers are given tips, tools, and techniques as to instruct students. However, there's little to no time in the school day in which students get to learn about themselves, themselves, or how they relate to the present reality and the power and the reality that they can create. A true statement is that students are being educated today for a world that does not exist yet. However, another true statement that I found in my experience is that teachers and educators and administrators are facilitating an environment in teaching students in a way that is now extinct and has been extinct for some time now. So there's a gap, and to be a leader is to be able to challenge that gap.
Mm. And how do you do that on a regular basis? Is it a lot of work? Or
it's I breathe it. You think about it in your sleep as well as in every waking statement. What I ultimately try to do is empower teachers to understand that they are politicians as well as educators. Politicians in the sense that they have a view, and their view should be heard, and their voice should be clear and distinctive, and it should build a power base, which would be the community that they're serving, to meet the needs that they see best fit for their students and their community. And in that, by doing that, they're just the politician as much one as the mayor and the governor, if not more important, because they are literally creating the future in both through human beings as well as through products from those human beings. So through that premise, then they understand how important their role is inside the four walls in which they conduct teaching practices as well as outside the four walls. The other motto that's very important is that we ought to treat each child as our own. And that's the starting point of expectations from administrators that I collaborate with as well as oversee and teachers. And when we are truly doing this right, then we will treat each child as our employer because we're solely there for them.
Yeah. What does it mean to be data-driven?
Well, it means to frequently review data, create a method in which everyone can receive it. I have a notion that I'm working on called real-time teachers. And when I use the word teachers, I mean loosely anyone in education. And so to be data-driven is to be a real-time educator or teacher, which means that you're able to collect data regularly, quickly review it, and use it to inform your next decision. However, my understanding on this is that data is everything. Everything is data. We receive data in every moment, in every breath we breathe. And so the questions that make great leaders are, what data are we looking at? And how are we going to use that data in a manner that's going to change what we have today? Einstein said, we have few answers because we're asking the wrong questions. And our data is based off of the questions that we ask. So if we ask completely different questions, we'll get new data and new practices and new results and new products or achievements from our efforts.